Now, the E3 2021 Direct for Nintendo is coming up in just about 7 days, and with that, there is a lot of excitement to be had. From brand new games being revealed by Nintendo to even updates on the games we are looking forward to the most, like the sequel to Breath of the Wild, Splatoon 3, Metroid Prime 4, and of course, Bayonetta 3. And maybe even the possibility of a new console being revealed by Nintendo, that being the Switch Pro. With so many possibilities for Nintendo's E3 Direct, it set expectations at an all-time high for Nintendo, and especially with the absence of a E3 Direct last year, it's got Nintendo fans like myself pretty antsy to figure out what Nintendo's play is going to be for this year's E3. In some ways, I think Nintendo is going to completely blow us away at this year's E3, but that will likely not happen. So I recommend we all keep our expectations low, so that way if they do blow us away with this Direct, we could be even more excited because it was kind of unexpected. Nonetheless, there is still a lot of excitement for Nintendo's E3 2021 Direct, and with that, we have to go over what the most likely predictions are for their conference in terms of software as well as the slight possibility of hardware. Granted, after the disappointment last week, I find it very hard to believe that the Switch Pro will be revealed before E3. Therefore, I think it's still a little ways away before we do get it announced. If by some miracle we do get the Switch revision announced before E3, I will also go over my possible predictions for that scenario as well. But regardless, here is what I think Nintendo's plans are for E3 2021. Starting off, we have one of the games that will likely become the game of show at E3 for me, and that is the sequel to Breath of the Wild. Obviously, if you remember the Direct in February of 2021, you will know that Nintendo has plans to showcase the sequel to Breath of the Wild sometime later this year. Obviously, that happened in February, and it is sometime later, so I would assume that we should be getting something at E3. I think our best bet is we will get a gameplay trailer for Breath of the Wild sequel that's most likely going to set us up for what the new Hyrule looks like, as well as the new antagonist of the game. Will the mysterious creature under Hyrule Castle end up being Ganondorf, or will it be another incarnation of Ganon? Now, with the gameplay trailer for the sequel to Breath of the Wild, I think it's also safe to say that we will get the title for the new game, as well as a release window. I don't know if we will get a release date for Breath of the Wild 2, but I do think at the very least we will get the title for Breath of the Wild 2. Being completely honest, it will sound weird not to call that game Breath of the Wild 2. It'll be Breath of the Wild 2 in our hearts, but I would love to call it by its actual name. Now, if by some chances we do get a reveal of the Nintendo Switch revision before E3, then I think that we will get the release date for the Breath of the Wild sequel. But if the console isn't showed off at E3, then I think we'll have to wait a little bit longer for that to happen. And furthermore, as I've said before, if we don't get the Switch revision this year, then we won't get Breath of the Wild 2 this year either. I do not see a world where Nintendo releases the Switch revision without Breath of the Wild 2 coming out at the same time. The next game that I have for Nintendo's E3 prediction has got to be Splatoon 3. In my mind, Splatoon 3 is one of the games that is going to be revealed at E3 because it's probably practically done. Let's be honest, whenever we look at Splatoon 1 versus Splatoon 2, there's not very many differences. I think Nintendo's been working on Splatoon 3 for a while now, and they rushed out Splatoon 2 to give them plenty of time to develop Splatoon 3. From the trailer that we've seen for Splatoon 3, the game looks incredible, and I cannot wait to see what the story has to tell. I think Splatoon 3 could be the best Splatoon game that we get, primarily because it looks like it's such a big jump from the previous games. So for the Nintendo E3 Direct, I think we're going to get another gameplay trailer as well as a release window for the game. I don't think we're going to get a concrete release date, but I do think it's going to happen before March of 2022. Then again, they could release it at the same time that they released Splatoon 2, which was July 21st of 2017. So maybe it's going to be another July window for Splatoon 3 as well. Either way, in terms of E3 reveals, I think this will be a safe option for Nintendo. I think we'll get a sneak peek of what the single player looks like, as well as the new multiplayer modes, as well as a hopeful co-op experience similar to what we got in Splatoon 2. Now, the next big reveal that we probably will get for Nintendo's Direct at E3 is a new Smash character for the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate lineup. Now, this is a very hot topic in the community right now. Are we gonna get Master Chief? Are we gonna get Sora in Smash? Or will we get Crash Bandicoot? Or will Nintendo stop the trolling and finally give us Waluigi in Smash Bros? Now, as much as I would love to see all of those games in Smash, the one thing that I would really appreciate seeing is a Ratchet and Clank in Smash Bros. Ultimate. I know Ratchet and Clank is not the most popular game, but it's a game that is true to my heart, and I think that it would make for a really cool Smash character. With the release of Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart this month, I think it would be super cool for Nintendo and Insomniac and PlayStation to collaborate and finally give us some characters that we want from the PlayStation universe. If I'm being honest, I don't see how we get Ratchet and Clank before we get Crash Bandicoot, but either way, I think we will get the new Smash character revealed for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate at E3 this year. Nintendo, I am giving you a pass to do a little bit of trolling and finally put Waluigi and Smash Bros. Those are obviously crazy predictions that Nintendo would likely never do, but either way, I am excited for a reveal for a character character nonetheless. What video game character do you want to see in Smash Brothers Ultimate? Be sure to sound off in the comments. Now, the next game that we will likely see is a new 2D Metroid game. There has been so many leaks and rumors regarding an upcoming 2D Metroid game, and obviously whenever there's smoke, there is usually fire, except whenever it comes to the Switch Pro. But either way, with it being Metroid's 35th anniversary, I think there is a slight chance that we will see a Metroid game, whether it be 2D or 3D or a Prime Trilogy, I don't know. But what I do know is we will likely see an appearance from Metroid at this year's E3. There's also been a lot of talk about an upcoming Donkey Kong game that is a 2.5 dimensional game, but I just don't think we will get it announced at this year's E3. But definitely keep that one on your radar. Next up, I think the games that we should be looking for a reveal at this year's E3 is a lot of third-party developer support. The Nintendo Switch has almost got like 100 million units. It might have even crossed it by now, but either way, it has got a lot of units out there. And with that, third-party developers and publishers see that, and we will almost definitely see a lot of support for third-party games on the platform, as well as indie games. I don't know if Nintendo is going to give us a lot of indie games this year. They usually leave those for their Nindie showcase. And with the absence of Hollow Knight Silksong, I really don't care about a single independent game that we get revealed at this year's E3, because existence is pain. Speaking of that, we will probably get a trailer for the upcoming Fortnite season that is rumored to have Rick and Morty in the game. So for all of you Fortnite players, we will likely see a story trailer at Nintendo's E3 Direct, but that is only if Nintendo decides to give Epic the spotlight, especially after Nintendo denied Epic rights to use Samus in Fortnite. Next up, we have to talk about the elephant in the room. Oh, nope, that is just Kirby. Indeed, we will likely see a reveal for a new Kirby game. The developers have practically confirmed that they are working on a new Kirby game for the Nintendo Switch, so I think there's a good chance for that game to be revealed. Now, I would say that I'd love to see Bayonetta 3 as well as Metroid Prime 4, but at this point, I don't even know if those games still exist. So rather than go down my tantrum of how I would love to have those games at E3, I'm not even gonna talk about them in this video. Next up, we have Pokemon Legends Arceus as well as Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. Nintendo's E3 is gonna have Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl as well as Pokemon Legends Arceus at this E3 show. It is almost inevitable, especially if we don't get a Pokemon Presents this week. It is pretty much a guarantee that we will have both of those games at the Nintendo E3 Direct. Now, those are just the games that I think it's safe to say will be at E3. Obviously, they might not happen. I'm not saying that they will. I would love to wish them into existence, but we won't know until the E3 Direct. Now, let's talk about the possibility of if Nintendo does reveal the Switch Pro, maybe even tomorrow before the big E3 day. I think that that would change the conference entirely. If we do end up getting the Switch Pro revealed, then I can almost guarantee that every game that I just talked about will all likely have Switch enhanced versions of games, for instance, Breath of the Wild, as well as an enhanced version of Breath of the Wild 2, as well as Legends Arceus, and so on and so forth. Our previous line of thinking is Nintendo is going to announce the Switch Pro before E3, so developers can show off their enhanced versions and optimized versions for the Nintendo Switch Pro. If the Switch Pro reveal doesn't happen, then we won't get those enhanced games at this year's E3. That'll probably happen later on. But either way, those are my predictions for Nintendo's E3 2021. That's going to wrap it up for my predictions. Thank you all for watching. This has been Wes, and I will talk to you on the next video.